Students, so last video we had discussed about how Vijayanagara dynasty is become very powerful and who are the important kings they came in that regions and what was the contribution they are given. So in this video, so we are discussing about next point, that is how this dynasty was become very weak, this Vijayanagara dynasty, because of Devaraya second came is one of the important powerful king in the dynasty, and Ariyara and Bukharaya and Krishnadevaraya also. So these are the people they came and they extended their dynasty. So this much of big dynasty, so how the dynasty was become very weak, or how this dynasty was declined. So that only now we want to know. So after the death of Krishnadevaraya, so they are saying in this place ruled by Achyutaraya and Sadashivaraya. So after that here they are saying when Sadashivaraya started to rule, is a minor, is a boy. And is not have that much of capacity to rule that much of big empire, means Vijayanagara empire. So that's why in this time Ramaraya, the son-in-law of Krishnadevaraya, he took power in the place of Vijayanagara dynasty. When Sadashivaraya he started to rule, so on that time is a minor and is a small boy and is not have that much of capacity to rule in Vijayanagara dynasty. So that's why here they're saying Ramaraya is a son-in-law of Krishnadevaraya. He took power and he started to rule in the region of Vijayanagara dynasty. So when he took responsibility, or when he became a king, there are so much of wars about of sultans. So when he done so much of wars, so many of wars, so enemies also created, increased. So here especially they are saying Deccan Sultanates, when they done attack of Vijayanagara dynasty, so due to a revenge for him is, means Ramaraya, so here they are saying Ramaraya, he also done so much of battles against Deccan Sultanates. So when he done so much of battles, here they are saying he captured Vijayapura and Golconda of Deccan Sultanates. So already the enemies are increased. So once again, when Ramaraya, when he done battle against once again Deccan Sultanates, so once again Deccan Sultanates all are become united to defeat Vijayanagara dynasty. But they have different opinion, different philosophy, but to defeat Vijayanagara dynasty, they have become united. So when they became united, because of the jealous and growth of Vijayanagara dynasty, they have very rich economically, they are very strong Vijayanagara dynasty. So we want to capture and we want to maintain that much of economical richness. So in that purpose only, Deccan Sultanates, they all are become united and they done battle against Vijayanagara dynasty. So when this lack of incident is happened, so after that year they are saying 23rd January 1565, the United Deccanate Sultanate Army, so they done battle against Vijayanagara Empire in the year of 1565, 23rd January. So when the battle started in the between United Deccan Sultanates and another side is, that is Vijayanagara dynasty. So on that time here they are saying this war done in the place of banks of Krishna river, and in this place Ramaraya was died. So when Ramaraya was died, so after that here they say Sultanates, they looted Vijayanagara dynasty, and in the time the son of Ramaraya, Tirumala and Venkata, they escaped in battlefield and they run away and they settled in, here they are saying, by Penukonda. Ramaraya, he died in battlefield, but his son Tirumala and Venkata, they escaped in battlefield and they settled in Penukonda. So after that here they are saying Aravidu dynasty, after that they started rule in the place of Penukonda in 1572 till 1646, and they ruled the regions of Penukonda, Chandragiri and Vellore. So these regions ruled by Aravidu family. So that means now we are knowing, that means four families how they ruled in Vijayanagara dynasty. One is Sangama, after that Salva and Thuluva, and last one is Aravidu. And we are discussed how this dynasty was declined in when Ramaraya, he came to power, he done so much of battles against enemies. So enemies also increased. So in that, one of the important result, all the sultanates, Deccan sultanates, become unit. They are united. And they done battle against Vijayanagara dynasty in 1565 in Rakasatangadi, in the river's banks of Krishna. So in that battle, Vijayanagara dynasty was defeated. So when Vijayanagara dynasty defeated, the dynasty was declined. After that, they settled in the place of Penukonda. So when this like of incident happened, so on that time in Vijayanagara dynasty, there are some of the small kings also came. So they become independent. They become very powerful because of, till that much time, Vijayanagara was one of the important and biggest and powerful dynasty. So when this biggest and powerful dynasty was declined, so small dynasty are become independent. And they also started rule in their regions. So for example, here they given, one is Mysuru and Keladi, Chitradurga and Yelahanka and Surapura. So these important chieftains means local leaders, local rulers, so they have become independent and they started their empire. So this leg we can see that demolish or destroying of Vijayanagara dynasty. In the battle of Rakasatangadi, the rule of Vijayanagara dynasty was ended. So this leg we can see some of the important points about the decline of Vijayanagara dynasty. So after that, next, now we want to know what was the contribution given by Vijayanagara dynasty in different sector, means in different field. So first one we want to know that in, so here they given administration contribution, means administrative contributions of Vijayanagara dynasty. So here we want to know Vijayanagara dynasty, they implemented central administration system. Means the full power controlled by only one person, that is king. So this like we can see central administration systems we can see in Vijayanagara dynasty. Here they adopted centralized administrative system, but they adopted decentralization also. But final decisions who will take in the dynasty, that is king. So these like we can see centralized and decentralized, both types of administrative systems we can see in Vijayanagara dynasty. And here they say in that administrative purpose they appointed some of the ministers because to assist a king. So in that purpose for only they appointed ministers also in local provinces level. For example, here they are saying in that administrative purpose they divided kingdoms as a different, here they are saying they divided kingdom to provinces. So after that, these provinces they divided as the regions, and in regions they made cities. After that, in cities they made villages. So these like for administrative purpose, for easy administrative purpose, they divided kingdoms in different stages: provinces, cities, villages and regions. So these like they divided a kingdom. And here they say kings is a managing in provinces, and in village level they are given hereditary officer. So they are looking in the place of village level. And next one point here they say in judicial system, one of the important and very strong judicial systems we can see in Vijayanagara dynasty. The full power is took by king. King is supreme judiciary in this dynasty. And regional officers, they are maintaining judicial system in province level. In provinces level, regional officers, they are looking that particular positions, a judicial system. So after that, here the main source of income in this Vijayanagara dynasty, here they are saying by land revenue. So 1/6. So this percentage of land revenue collected by this dynasty. And not only this one tax, they implemented, there are different types of land tax. Means there are different types of tax also they implemented in this dynasty. So here they are saying one is income and trade tax, professional tax, road tax, fair tax, export tax and tribute cash. So these like we can see there are different income sources of this dynasty. Not only land tax, they collected source in different way to rule or to develop a Vijayanagara dynasty. And next one here is saying, so in that time we can see there are different types of army in Vijayanagara dynasty. So here is saying infantry, cavalry, elephant and cannons. So these like we can see there are four types of army we can see in Vijayanagara dynasty. And next one here they are saying, here not only this one of the important force in that dynasty, that is Arabian horses. So these also, these like a force, or these also they used for a war purpose. So in that purpose only they purchased Arabian horses. So this like we can see the administrative system of Vijayanagara dynasty. King is one of the important powerful person. They adopted centralized and decentralized administrative system, and they divided kingdom as a different types because to administrative purpose, and they collected different types of land tax, and they made different types of army force also. So this is one of the important, and we can see a systematic administrative system we can see or we can found in the place of Vijayanagara dynasty. So after the administrative system, we can see next one is, that is social system of Vijayanagara dynasty. In this social system, so here they say they practiced different types of culture. So here they say, here we can see child marriage and sati system and devadas system. So these are the important practice done by Vijayanagara peoples. And next one here they say monogamy also practiced by rich peoples. A person, you can marry 2, 3, 4. So this like of system also we can see in that Vijayanagara dynasty. And women's, they are given equal importance. Women for also they are given equal importance. And in that time in social system, here they say they started some of the important festivals to celebrate. One is Deepavali and second one is Dasara. So these are the important festivals celebrated the peoples of Vijayanagara dynasty. But in that Dasara, so this is one of the important contribution of Vijayanagara dynasty. So on that time, this Dasara was started, festival started under the leadership of kings. Kings only, they patronized Dasara. They only started the festival of Dasara. So this like we can see the social system of Vijayanagara dynasty. So after that, next one we want to know, that is economic conditions of Vijayanagara dynasty. So in that time, agriculture, this is one of the important work of Vijayanagara peoples. So this is one of the important work. So here they are saying peoples, they produce, there are different types of crops. Maize, rice, sugarcane, cotton. So these are the important crops. Here they are saying these are the important crops produced by Vijayanagara peoples. And here they are saying, and kings also, they are given equal importance in the field of agriculture. So they also built some of the tanks to produce agriculture crops. In that purpose only they built tanks and wells also. And not only this one, they started links between other countries. So what was the things they produced? So that one, they want to export to other countries. So in that purpose, they started international trade also. So here they say rice, cotton, cloth, iron and diamonds, sugar, musk, sandal and spices. So these are the things Vijayanagara peoples, they started to export to other countries. And some of the things they imported. Here they say, so one is horse, silk cloth, and here again mukmal cloth. So these are the important things they imported in other countries. So these like in Vijayanagara dynasty of economic condition, they established an international trade relationship. Some of the things they exported, some of the things Vijayanagara peoples are imported. So these like we can see. And here they say Vijayanagara, this is one of the important international business for a diamonds. For diamonds, Vijayanagara dynasty, this is a international business place. So that like also we can see. And cloth weaving industry also we can see in Vijayanagara dynasty. And how they exported, these are the things by a port. So here they say in Bhatkal, 1 hour, Mangalore. So these are the important port on that time. So in that place, they started to export and imported the things. And in that time, Vijayanagara dynasty peoples, they knowing to use the golden coins. So this also one of the important. And here they saying in that golden coin, they used the picture of God and Godness. So these pictures they used in that coins, and this only they used as a currency. So this like we can see the economic conditions of Vijayanagara dynasty. So after that, next one here they given, that is the literature of Vijayanagara dynasty. when Vijayanagara dynasty they started to rule, they given equal importance for literature also, not only one language. So in that time, yeah, they say Sanskrit, Telugu and Kannada, these three language also developed. Means kings, they patronized these three language also, Sanskrit, Telugu and Kannada. So here they are saying some important literature works of Vijayanagara dynasty. So one is here they given Vidyaranya, he written a book Shankara Vijaya and Sarva Darshana Sangraha in Sanskrit language. And his brother, here they given Sahanacharya, he also written a books. One is Vedanta Prakasha and Ayurveda Sudhanidhi. And not only scholars or poets they came in these regions, and not only they are written a books, kings also, they also written some of the books. So here they given, so one is here they given Ganga Devi, she written a book Madhura Vijayam, and Prouda Devaraya, he written a drama, so that is Sudhanidhi, and Krishna Devaraya written Chambuvati Kalyana, Mandala Sacharita and Rasamanjari, and Kumaravasa he written book Gadugina Bharata, Ratnakaravarni he written Bharatesha Vaibhava, Chamarasas Prabhulinga Lile. So these are the important books we can see in Kannada language. And Lankarnas, he also written, here they given Shiva Tattva Chintamani, and Bhima, so he also written a book that is Basava Purana. So this also we are getting in about the Veerashaiva literature. So these, like the kings, is they not only a brave leaders, so they also written some of the books. And next one here they are saying about the Krishna Devaraya, is not only a brave leader or famous king. So when Krishna Devaraya started to rule, so in that time the Telugu language was patronized, that is well developed. So here they are saying Krishna Devaraya, when he given this much of contribution about the Telugu language, so that's why he got a title that is Andhra Bhoja. And he written one of the important book that is Amukta Molyada in the language of Telugu. So these like they saying, and not only this one, not only is a writer, he also given encouragement to other king, other scholars. So here they saying he appointed 8 important scholars. So for them he given name as a Ashtadiggajas. So here they given some of the important names in Ashtadiggajas. So one is Allasani Peddana, Nandi Timmanna, Srinatha, Pingali Suranna and Tenali Ramakrishna. So these are the important leaders in that Ashtadiggajas. So these, like the kings, they not only a brave leaders, they also written some of the books, and they also increased language and literature also in Kannada, Sanskrit and Telugu. These three language also developed in the time of Vijayanagara dynasty. So after that, next one we want to know, that is religious system of Vijayanagara dynasty. So when already we are discussed in Bukkaraya period, so here the kings are developed religious harmony between in different sect. So here they saying they built mosque also in their particular empire. So this one is showing how the kings of Vijayanagara, they implemented equality among a different caste or different peoples. And next one here they saying, when we already knowing that one, in Shravana Badaga inscriptions of 1368, here we already knowing when Vaishnavas, and here they saying already when Jains and Vaishnavas, when they started a problems about of their philosophy, so on that time Bukkaraya, he took a leadership and he solved. So this one is showing kings are given equal importance for all the sect. And another point also here they are saying, when Barbosa, when he visited the Krishna Devaraya kingdom or dynasty, so on that time he observed there are different types of sect or caste or religious peoples, they live as a happily, they move their life as a happily. So this also mentioned his book. His book is Barbosa, when he visited his dynasty, Vijayanagara dynasty, he observed the situation, social system of Vijayanagara dynasty. Here there are different types of religious peoples, Muslim, Jews, Christian or Hindus, they are living as a peaceful and happily. So these like mentioned by Barbosa. So this only they are showing the Vijayanagara dynasty, they are given equal importance for all the religion, not only one or two religion, for all the religion peoples or for all the religion, they are given equal importance. And next one we want to know, last point about Vijayanagara dynasty, that is art and sculptures of Vijayanagara dynasty. So when we are discussing about art and sculptures of Vijayanagara dynasty, here one of the important great historian, so that person name is Percy Brown. So he described the style of Vijayanagara dynasty, the monuments and the sculptures, so temples, the structures of temples. So he described as the Vijayanagara dynasty, the evolutionary form of Dravidian style. So this Dravidian style introduced by Vijayanagara dynasty. So these like described by Percy Brown because of the contributions of Vijayanagara dynasty in the field of art and sculptures. And we want to know here, they built, there are so much of important temples in Vijayanagara dynasty. So here they are saying one by one. So they used strong granite rocks to build a temples. And here they are saying, so here they given one by one, Kalyana Mantapa of Virupaksha temple in Hampi, and Azara Ramaswamy temple, and Vitala Swami temple, and another one is Krishna Swami temple, Kamala Mahal, Sringeri's Vidyashankara temple. So these are the important temples built by Vijayanagara dynasty. And so when we are discussing about the temples of Vijayanagara, we want to see some of the important features of the dynasty, of the temples. So here they are saying, first one is, each temples also we can see same features. So one by one here they are given, spacious enclosures we can see top. So this is one of the spacious. And next one here they are given, high towers we can see in Vijayanagara dynasty temples. And very wide marriage halls also we can found in these temples or in this area. And meeting halls and spring pavilions. So these like of features commonly we can found in Vijayanagara dynasty. And next one here they are saying, these like of temples as sculptures art we can found in different places also. So here they are given Kalahasti, Sri Shaila, Tirupati, and here they are given Chidambaram, Sri Rangam, and Kumbakonam, Kanchi. So in that regions also we can found the art and architectures or sculptures of Vijayanagara dynasty. And not only a temples, they given some other contributions also. Here they given stone chariot, idols of Narasimha and Ganapati, these also important contributions of Vijayanagara dynasty. Because of these idols, they built a single rock, that means monolith, that means a single rock, they built a sculptures, idols. So this is also one of the important contribution. And in that time, one of the important music also introduced by Vijayanagara dynasty. So here they are saying that only Dakshinandi music, that means in present we are given name as a Carnatic music. So this Carnatic music introduced in the period of Vijayanagara dynasty. So on that time one of the important person came, that is Purandaradasa and Kanakadasa. So they are given so much of contribution in the field of Carnatic music. And so on that time when the Carnatic music was developed, the common people also, they also got a knowledge about a social system. So these like we can see art and architecture's contributions of Vijayanagara dynasty. Not only temples, they built idols also and sculptures. And not only this one, on that time they given equal importance for music also, especially Carnatic music. They came or they developed or started in the time of Vijayanagara dynasty. So these like we can see some of the important points about the contributions of Vijayanagara dynasty in the field of administrative system and social system, economic system. And we have discussed about art and architectures, and another one is religious system. So these like we can see the contributions of Vijayanagara dynasty. Okay, next class we can discuss about next another important lesson. Okay, thank you.